Excepting one place, I will just cite to you. But I have to speak on certain things. Cheat funds enacted in 1982. From 1982, the cheat funds are working. There are the regulatory agencies. There are unauthorized cheat funds who are being run. Why the regulatory agencies like Reserve Bank of India, SEBI, did not act. No step had been taken by RBI and the SEBI at all. This is my first contention. Why? Why did they not? Had they have taken these steps, we would not have faced this situation at all. Right from 82. It is not from yesterday. Therefore, why not from 1982 steps have not been taken and allowed to run the cheat fund without having any license? And why they have not able to catch the persons who are running this unauthorized cheat funds at all? Now, sir, I just inform you, is a cheat fund is a valid business? Is it true? Sponge schemes are invalid? Is it true? If cheat fund is valid and sponge scheme is invalid, how a common people will make a distinction of the cheat fund and the sponge scheme? What are the procedure? Sir, recently we have come to learn that the standing committee's meeting, that which is being referred to, one of the members of the committee put a question to the governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Why the title is cheat fund? The Reserve Bank of India has answered it. It is not CHEAT fund, but CHIT. Right? If that's so, how a common man, will just understand what is a sponge scheme and what is a cheat fund scheme? That's the basic question. That has created the confusion of the entire thing. Sir, a businessman, suppose runs newspaper, film maker, film producer, the real estate businessman comes to any person, including a politician, and describes themselves as, I am a filmmaker, I am a businessman running a state business. I have to take it on his face value. Whether he is running by the cheat fund or sponge scheme, who will know? Sir, I will be appealing to the Honorable MOS. He's present here. Through you, kindly communicate to the Honorable Prime Minister even. Our opinion is that from tomorrow you ban the entire cheat fund. Ban it. Cheat fund should be banned. This is our opinion. Why there should be? Sir, so far this matters are a concern, I'll take something.
Time is limited.
I understand, sir. You have kindly do not cut down whenever.
I can't.
Sir, I become a bit nervous when the moment you come here, sir. Because of the cutting of the time. I was so happily I was sitting that guy, Jagannath Ji ka representative was there. But sir, just sir, anyway. Sir, see, I tell you, sir, I have told, I said to him also. Sir, I am coming. Sir, in Sarda matters which is not being referred to, the Supreme Court, in his judgment in Subrata Chattaraj, at paragraph 25, I just read it. Quote, the Honorable MOS, kindly hear this. Quote, paragraph 25. There is another aspect to which we must advert at this stage. This relates to the role of the regulatory authorities. The investigation conducted so far puts a question mark on the role of regulatory authorities like SEBI, Register of Companies and Officials of RBI, within whose respective jurisdiction and areas of operation this scam not only took part, but flourished unhindered. Mr. Synopsis filed by Mr. So-and-so named some of the officials belongs to these authorities and give reasons why their role needs to be investigated. The Honorable Finance Minister, please. Talk with your colleague later on, please. Paragraph 20. Just a minute. I want to draw his attention. The synopsis, hear the language of the Supreme Court. The synopsis goes to the extent of suggesting that regular payments towards bribes were paid through middlemen to some of those who are supposed to keep an eye on such Ponzi companies. The regulatory authorities, it is common ground, exercise the powers and jurisdiction under central legislation. Possible connivance of those who are charged with the duty of preventing the scams of such nature of breach of the law, therefore, needs to be closely examined. And ultimately, Supreme Court has also directed to make an investigation against them. Now, is there any investigation against the RBI? No. Is there any investigation against the SEBI?
No.
Any RBI has been interrogated? Any CBI authority has been interrogated? Any regulatory agency has been interrogated? Any person has been arrested? Any person has been arrested? Supreme Court has clearly saying they are taking bribes. They are taking bribes. It is the language of the Supreme Court, not my language. Therefore, what is the steps? You are giving the power to the RBI. You are giving the power to the SEBI through the agency. You are creating a competent authority. I don't mind. But the question is whether they are working or not. They are not at all working. Sir, there are acts also. Like in our state also, must be in Kerala also there. Our state also, the act is the West Bengal Protection of Interest of Depositors in Financial Establishment Act 2013, which an assent has been given in 2015. President's assent have got it. Now the bill has come. I have only one point so far in respect of the bill. I am not going to any other part. Sir, you know that the whenever in the law and order, it comes within the seventh schedule, second list.
Entry one.
Right. Therefore, if any offense is committed, it would be the state's power. Now, what is being done? Under section 30, subsection 2, fortunately you are here. I will get the chance to speak on the legal things. The reference made by the competent authority under subsection 1 shall be deemed to be with the consent of the state government. Sir, you know, this deeming clause is a legal fiction, nothing more than that. It's a legal fiction. Can a legal fiction, can be made an explicit legal provision in one statute at all? It cannot be done. So, but therefore, you are taking away, you are interfering with the power of the state itself. Let's understand. Suppose a crime has been committed at Kerala. Then the Kerala police officer, etc., have the jurisdiction. He can also come to the West Bengal also. Therefore, why this power, this is a jurisdiction, you are really hitting the federal structure of the Constitution itself. Can you, sir, the question is whether a power which is under the second list of the seventh schedule can be exercised in an indirect manner under the list one of the seventh schedule? The question is this. Therefore, this portion really ultra virus. This portion really ultra virus. There cannot be any deeming provision, sir. Sir, I have another thing to say and I will finish it. Why the people this are running for? These cheap funds, Ponzi funds, etc. Why? Reason is simple. Ground reality is this. Every day you are deducting the interest. Every day you are deducting the interest. Either bank interest or this small space saving interest. Everywhere. A common man, a pensioner, a widow, a divorced woman, a poor man, they depend upon this small saving, or he just passes on his days on the basis of interest. If therefore it is the government, rather you are forcing, you are pushing the people, common people, poor people, go indulging. Go and take money from their loan. In an indirect manner you are doing it. It should not be done. If you want to stop it, if you want to stop the sponge scheme, if you want to prohibit it, you prohibit chit fund, you also do increase your interest so that people must get the interest itself. Otherwise not. Sir, another last, I will finish it. I have heard so many things. I have heard so many comments. We have heard Sarda, so many, Dal Rose Valley, so many things. My question is today, proceeding in the floor of the parliament, today my question is to you, before the nation, lest the lesson nation knows, when the Supreme Court has done it? In 2014. CBI is making an investigation. It is a 2019. Charge sheet has been filed. Why not the trial? This has been begun. Why the trial has not been commenced? Sir, speedy trial is also a right unprotected under Article 21. Sir, an accused, similarly a victim, both are enjoying the right under Article 21 on the Constitution. Both are enjoying. If both are enjoying the right under Article 21 of the Constitution of India, why a domestic sword would be hung upon a person years together, and he has to hear all the bad words which can be used against him in the country, and he should be blamed decades after decades. You are an accused. Why the CBI will not complete the trial itself, sir? This is my question. This is my, I need an answer. You do it. If you think I have committed an offense, you throw me into the jail. I don't mind. I am not saying. I am not opposing. I am not saying, sir. I am not saying you do it. If I have committed an offense, you send me out of the prison. But do it quickly. Don't put the domestic sword on my shoulder.
You have made your point, I think.
Domestic sword on my shoulder. Sir,
absolutely,
yes,
you have made your point.
Thank you, sir. You have given me time. I am grateful to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Sri Kalyan Banerjee. Next speaker, Sri B. Chandrasekhar. Sri B. Chandrasekhar.
Honorable Speaker, sir. At the offset, I would like to thank you.
You please don't cross them. Honorable Minister, please, you address here, please.
Yes, sir.
No. nothing is there on record. Go, please. See, Honorable Minister, you have absolute right to intervene in... Please, Kalyan Banerjee, please be seated, please.
I have every right to help my colleague. What is wrong in it?
Please, Honorable Minister, you have absolute... right to intervene in the debate at any time if you want, because it is the prerogative right of the Minister to intervene in a debate, no doubt about it. But what suggested is, when... another honorable member is speaking, kindly have the patience to hear.